All right, sweet. Shalom, shalom, Akyam. Looks good. Yeah, we looking pretty, are we? Yeah, I don't know, the stream seems, okay, it seemed like it's kind of bumping in and out. We're going to go with it, though, through the spirit. Is your brother Aria? Shalom, is your brother Aria from the GMS Tampa Bay 12 camp, GMS 13 rulership, my personal page. First and foremost, I want to start by giving all praise, honor, and glory to our Lord Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Racha, Badash. Giving double honors to our elders and our apostles at Great Millstone, rule and teach well. Salutations to Carl Akim around the four corners of the globe, pushing his word in truth and sincerity. Shalom to any sisters as well, too, that may be listening to the spirit. May Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai continue to bless you and your families. And again, it's Aria from Tampa. Back at you again with another live lesson through the spirit. And as you can see by the title of the lesson, it says, it's time to grow up, man. You know, and really, it's been time to grow up. I mean, this is just a title, you know, for the lesson, nothing major. It's just a title, but, you know, and the scriptures I'm going to bring out, you know, a few of them, they tell you, you know, hey, man, we know we're not children anymore. All right, we're grown men. All right, this word essentially has, you know, is made you a man. You know, once you heard, got the understanding of the truth, that brought you back. You think you were a man before. Once you heard this truth, this, you know, scriptures say you got to make yourself as a little child, you know, spiritually, so what, you can continue to restart over again and grow up and be a man. These scriptures make you a man. The understanding of these scriptures make you grown. They make you a man. This completes a man. That's why this is something that all brothers should be praying for, is the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. The secrets, the mysteries that are hidden to the rest of the world, but is made plain unto the men of the Lord. If these scriptures and the understanding of these scriptures and these breakdowns are plain to you, then you're really you're on your way to manhood if you're not already a man. But the ways of the world, they continue to pollute, you know, brothers, you know, I myself, you know, the ways of the world, they continue to pollute you, and they'll send you back a few notches if you're not careful. All right. You know, as one scripture says here, and I bring it out a lot, but, you know, we're going to continue to bring these scriptures out in the book of Romans. Where is it? Chapter 12, verse 2. It says, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of the Most High. So don't conform yourself to the ways of the world. The world is, this world is not long for the earth. You know, the ways of the world is not long for existence on this earth, because the Lord's about to do away with everything. You conform yourself to the ways of this world just so you can fit in. That's not something a man would do. That's something that children do. That's something that high schoolers do. All right? Trying to fit in. All right? The scripture says, I'll read it again, Romans 12 and 2. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. All right? So we conform ourselves. We don't conform ourselves, but we transform ourselves. We used to conform our ways to the world, but now we transform ourselves from the world into an actual true man. Into righteousness, onto the path of righteousness. Not the path of darkness and doom and destruction, but the path of righteousness, the path of salvation. Okay? So don't conform yourself to what everybody out here is doing. Yeah, I mean, we understand that we do have to play an incognito role to an extent. We have to play the game, it's playing the game. You're not selling your soul out to all the stuff of the world, to your job and you know, fashion or whatever the case may be. You're not selling your soul to all those things, but you're conforming to the world so they don't question, all right, what's this guy, where's his head at? All right, your mind should be away from all that, what do people think about me? Man, I want to get this, maybe I should buy that, maybe I should get involved in this and do that. But the last thing in your mind is serving Yahweh Hashem Yahshai, serving the Lord in truth and sincerity. That's the furthest thing from your mind. Maybe I should try to expand my spirituality. Maybe I need to find out why I'm here on this earth. What's my purpose here on this earth? You made the money already. You've gotten the women already. What else is there? You got to figure out what your purpose is on this earth. You being a so-called black man, Hispanic man, or Native American, you should have a lot of questions about what your purpose is on this earth. Because we're the only ones that get the shit end of the stick. But once you start coming to realization that the world was actually made for your sake and for our people's sake, that you should start carrying yourself maybe in a different light, you know? When you start reading these scriptures and getting the breakdown and understanding, you know what? Scriptures keep talking about how we kings and princes and all these things, we're the princes of power, and you should start acting like it, all right? You should start carrying yourself in that manner. Having a little more confidence in your steps in life. All right? And trying to actually play the role, all right? And live that role. I mean, you're not going to be walking around with a crown on your head and gold dripped all over your body. A little gold here and there, but, you know, we're not, you know, got a big ass crown on with jewels and diamonds. And we don't got it. We're not in our king, in our rulership yet. So there is still a humility that we still carry ourselves with. The world is going to be given into the meek. All right? So all the things that we chase in the flesh in this world, all that's going to be burnt up. Let's get that real quick. And we'll get into the lesson. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 11. It says, "Seeing then that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of persons ought ye to be? In holy conversation, in godliness, looking forward and hasting unto the coming of the day of the Lord, wherein the heaven being on fire shall be dissolved, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat." What manner of person ought you to be, knowing that this stuff is going to happen on the earth? All the things that our flesh lusts after here in the earth, all that's going to be dissolved. It's going to melt away with the elements when the destruction comes. Knowing that, how should you be carrying yourself out here? Should you still be chasing the bag? Should you still be chasing all types of tail out here, all these different women? Or should you try to broaden your horizon in these scriptures and get a deeper understanding and prophecy? Maybe you should be worrying about how you should be an example. Rather, you trying to find the example out there. You already found the example if you're watching these videos. Not necessarily my videos, but yeah, my videos and countless brothers all across the planet Earth. Those are your examples that you should be following. The men of the scriptures, these men that are written about in the scriptures, these are the men that we should be following. These are our superheroes. These are our role models. These are the examples that the Lord, the one the world ignorantly just calls God, the Most High, He set these people up and He set these examples up so that we don't have to question it. It's right here. Everything else is a distraction. What manner of person ought ye to be? Holy conversation, godliness, looking for and hastening unto the day, the coming of the Lord. Knowing that the elements are going to dissolve with fervent heat. Come on, bro. It's time to tighten up. It's time to put on our big boy pants and accept the fact that everything that we know and love out here is going to be destroyed real soon. Real soon. Like, time is, get right. Otherwise, you're not going to make it. You're going to be one of the ones that are going to die in fervent heat. Now, we're going to continue to make these videos, and we're going to continue to push the fact that hell is coming on this earth. And if you still have the mindset of a child, you have the mindset of a high schooler or a middle schooler still, you're not going to make it, okay? You're going to get so far until you run out of gas and something bad happens. Let's go to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 11. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. When I was a child, I spake as a child. Okay? I understood as a child. I thought as a child. Read that part again. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. And the funny thing is, a lot of these men out here, these so-called men that you see, you know, at your job or, you know, on your street, you know, throughout your day-to-day, you run grown men. These men still think as children, still understand as children. Women too. Okay? They speak as children. Their vocabulary only goes so far. Like, you try to talk to some of these people out here and have a conversation with them, they don't have they don't even have a vocabulary, you know, that's deep enough, you know, to really go far in any kind of meaningful conversation. They're speaking like children. They're speaking in nothing but slang and don't know how to type. Don't know the difference between there, and there. And these kind of people. You know, they don't understand. They speak as a child. They think as a child. They're not spiritual. They're very, very carnal. And I'm talking about, you know, so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. The heathen are one thing, but you so-called Blacks, Hispanics, Latinos, Native Americans, this is specifically for you, since you are the Israelites. You have a very dumbed down way of culture. That's why we're in the position we are right now. The Lord put us in this position, and to have all these other nations above us. But there's a small percentage of men, all right, within the nation of Israel, all right, that do not speak as a child. So reading on, I'll read it again. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. So, when do you become a man? When you get the true understanding of these holy scriptures. Once you have that true understanding of the Bible, you start getting into the deep mysteries and the parables and the breakdowns and you know, understanding the law, understanding the history and our forefathers, these stories and what they really mean. This is what shapes you into being a man. Because now you start putting and taking on the characteristics of our forefathers, which are true, true men to the core. This is the example that we need to be led by. And I always go into it, a lot of different lessons in the past that go over leading by example. All right, be that man that's written about in these scriptures. You be the man. You be him. All right, because you have others that are looking in from the outside, trying to get understanding on where they need to go in life, and you know you have the answers, and you are obligated to give those answers out to the needy. We're not children anymore. All right, there's a scripture that says, you know, in malice be children, and you know, whatever, you know, but in truth and in righteousness, you know, be ye men. You know, roughly paraphrasing, extremely rough. But that's how we need to be. We need to be as men. All right? Knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Faith, patience, confidence. All right, which is faith. Discernment. Strength, mental strength. Physical strength too. You know, keep yourself healthy. This is what makes you a man. Hell is about to break loose on the earth. I can't stress it enough. And if you're still in that child mindset, you're still in that high school mindset, you're gonna have a bad time. Verse 12, for now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as I am known. And now abideth faith, hope, charity, these three. But the greatest of these is charity, you know, and a true man is charitable, okay? He isn't stingy, all right? He deals with his brothers if they're needy, his family if they need anything, He tries to provide. He tries to be a pillar, you know, whether it be in the ministry, whether it be in his family, but in his faith altogether. You got to be a pillar in the faith. All right? And these characteristics is what makes you a man. Again, going into, it says what? Faith, hope, charity. Okay? Most importantly, charity. Let's get another scripture here. Let's go to 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians, what do I want? Yeah, let's read this. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of the Most High. Okay, so we have to what? It says we have to cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit. So once you hear this word is supposed to what? Clean you. Wash you. This is the true baptism. When you listen to these videos, if you don't know anything about the Bible and you start listening to brothers speak, you know, from the Great Millstone or like-minded camps, you hear the words, you hear the precepts, the scriptures come out, the breakdown. This is the baptism. This is what washes you. Read it again. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of the Most High. Okay? Perfecting holiness in the fear of the Heavenly Father. That's another thing. Fear of the Heavenly Father. Fear of the unseen power. Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushai. That is our power. And that is the power that is going to destroy the remnant of the heathen. Or not the remnant of the heathen, excuse me. That's going to destroy the enemy, which are the heathen. And 2/3 of our own people who are heathen-like. Gentiles in a mind. If you don't fear the Heavenly Father, then you are a fool. If you don't believe in the Heavenly Father, you're a fool. A fool has said in his heart, there is no God. There is no power. So we have to do better. The Word cleanses us. The Word cleanses us. We let the Word, we let it seep in. We get the understanding. It clicks. And then we realize, oh man, we are the Israelites. Oh man, this is something I should be doing. How do you serve the Lord? You start figuring out how to serve the Lord. The answers are all here. That's what makes you a man. You start as a child and then you become a man. It's time to grow up. If you don't do it now, you're going to be too late. When all the bad things start happening, and it's going to start happening soon. It's happening now. Precursor to what's about to come. We're talking about famine, pestilence, war, violence, fires, drought, natural disasters. Not so natural disasters. The Lord's going to bring it all. Let's go to 2 Timothy. Oh man, it's almost 9. I'm not even home. I got, you know, the brothers, you know, I'm in a Tampa camp and we got a live stream coming up at 9. And it's 9 o'clock now. Good job timing, Aria. I might be able to get in there late if the brothers let me in. Let me try to make this quick. So in the book of what? 2 Timothy. Right here. 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 19. We'll start there. Nevertheless, the foundation of the Most High standeth sure, having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are his. And let every one that nameth the name of Hamashiach depart from iniquity. Alright, so those that call upon Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, alright, depart from iniquity. You're not calling on the name in vain. You're calling on that name because you believe and you worship that power. And what do? You depart from your ways. You transform. You're not conformed. You transform from the ways of the world and you start following the ways of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. And if you make a mistake, you repent. You ask for forgiveness. And try not to do it again. Simple as that. Verse 20, But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. If a man therefore purge himself of these, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified, and meet for the master's use, and prepared unto every good work. So we want to make ourselves as that gold and that silver. We can't make ourselves as that, but The scriptures say to make your calling and election sure. So do what you know that you need to do according to what you've learned through the spirit of the Bible to make yourself of that elect. Because you can't just make yourself, but you can do everything that the elect would be doing if you really believe they're here today. You do believe they're here today, right? They are. So you want to be doing everything in your power to follow the example of the elect. And it's all in the Bible. Follow those men and their example, and it'll lead you to life. Verse 22. 2 Timothy chapter 2 and 22. Flee also youthful lusts, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace, with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. So we have to, again, it says flee from youthful lusts. And then it goes into what we should be following. It says, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace. Because if you're calling on the Lord, you more than likely have a pure heart. You know the name and you call on the Lord in secret and private. Because you believe. I really hope this is recording. Now I see it has a weak signal. Let's go with it. I have a feeling it's playing me. Next scripture, let's go to 1 Timothy. Now, yeah, we'll make this quick because it looks like everything's getting fucked up. It's part of my language. 1 Timothy chapter 4. Let's see. 1 Timothy chapter 4. Let's start at verse 12. It says, let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, there it is again, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. So we are not to despise our youth, but we are to actually be examples unto them. And then it goes ahead and it lists those godly attributes. Verse 13, till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. All right, so what do? We keep building ourselves up, as men do. We build ourselves up. We read, we get understanding. All right, we walk in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. All right, pure heart. We give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine, to only true doctrine. Neglect not the gifts that is in thee, okay, which is given thee by prophecy with the laying of the hands of the presbytery. Okay, so the gifts that were given unto us, you know, may have a different gift than I have. All brothers have their own different gifts. All right, use it, exploit it. It helps build up those that are knocked down. We have to do this, man. This isn't an option anymore. This is what we need to be doing. All right? It's time to grow. It's time to evolve. Because if you're not trying, then, you know, you're not going to make it too far. Let's go to the book of Psalms, chapter 119 and verse 9. It says, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? That's a question. Wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? The answer, by taking heed thereto according to thy word. So you cleanse your ways by taking heed to the word. All right? Once you take heed to the word and you understand what you need to be doing, now your path has been cleansed. Now you're on your way to manhood. Now you can start teaching. Now you're on your way to being a teacher or showing yourself to be a prophet. Proving yourself to be of the elect. You see it? And then we'll go to 1 Peter. We'll end this lesson with this scripture here. 1 Peter chapter 2. I think this is what I want. Yeah, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse... I want to say... It'll start at verse 11 and read on down to 14. So 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 11. Dearly beloved, I beseech you as strangers and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts, which war against the soul. So we abstain from our fleshly lusts. All right, to the best of our ability. All right, try. And it, I mean, if you're going off, if it's taking over your path or your walk in the faith, then you must abstain for it. If it's taking too much attention from the your walk in the faith, you must abstain from it. I'm talking to myself first and foremost. I'm saying you, but I'm talking to myself first and foremost. I can see myself in the camera. It says, abstain from fleshly lusts, which war against the soul. Having your conversation honest among the Gentiles, that whereas they speak against you as evildoers, they may by your good works, which shall behold, glorify the Most High in the day of visitation. So we are to what? It says having your conversation honest among the Gentiles. Because our people are just like Gentiles, all right? Just like we used to be. So we want to have our conversation honest among them. We are the walking, we are a walking beacon of light to them. And they see us. So that, yeah, they may talk shit about us, but at the same time, there may be a chance because the elect is walking amongst these people in the darkness. So there's a chance that they see you walking the way you walking. And they may start asking you questions to start following you, thus following Yahweh Bashem Yahushar. Alright, we'll end it there. So with that, I'm gonna give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bashem Yahushar, Bashem Rakak Wadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of GMS, great millstone, who rule and teach well. Salutation to call Akim out there, pushing toward the truth and sincerity. And Mo'af Lababal, peace, y'all.